Good morning and welcome back to all of us who are gathered here in church, and also welcome to those who are joining us through live streaming. Today is the 18th Sunday after Trinity. We begin our service by singing the hymn, Love Divine, All Loves Excelling. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all men. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our fellow men in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, increase in us your gift of faith, that forsaking what lies behind and reaching out to that which is before, we may run the way of your commandments and win the crown of everlasting joy. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The Old Testament reading is from the book of Genesis, chapter 2, beginning with verse 18 to verse 24. Genesis chapter 2, verse 18 to 24. Then the Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to live alone. I will make a suitable companion to help him." So he took some soil from the ground and formed all the animals and all the birds. Then he brought them to the man to see what he would name them. And that is how they all got their names. So the man named all the birds and all the animals, but not one of them was a suitable companion to help him. Then the Lord God made the man fall into a deep sleep, and while he was sleeping, he took out one of the man's ribs and closed up the flesh. He formed a woman out of the rib and brought her to him. Then the man said, "At last, here is one of my own kind, bone taken from my bone and flesh from my flesh. Woman is her name because she was taken out of man." That is why a man leaves his father and mother and is united with his wife, and they become one. This is the word of the Lord.
The epistle reading is taken from St. Paul's letter to the Hebrews, chapter 1, verses 1 to 4, and chapter 2, verses 5 to 12. Beginning from, to read from chapter 1, verse 1. In the past, God spoke to our ancestors many times and in many ways through the prophets. But in these days, in these last days, He has spoken to us through His Son. He is the one through whom God created the universe, the one whom God has chosen to possess all things at the end. He reflects the brightness of God's glory and is exact likeness of God's own being, sustaining the universe with His powerful word and achieving forgiveness for the sins of all human beings. He sat down in heaven at the right-hand side of God, the supreme power. The Son was made greater than the angels, just as the name that God gave Him is the greater than theirs. Chapter 2, verse 5. God has not placed the angels as rulers over the new world to come, the world of which we speak. Instead, as it is said somewhere in the scriptures, "What are human beings, O God, that you should think of them? Mere human beings that you should care for them. You may make them for a little while lower than the angels. You crown them with glory and honor, and make them rulers over all things." It says that God made them rulers over all things. This clearly includes everything. We do not, however, see human beings ruling over all things now, but we do see Jesus, who for a little while was made lower than the angels, so that through God's grace He should die for everyone. We see Him now crowned with glory and honor because of the death He suffers. It was only right that God, who creates and preserves all things, should make Jesus perfect through suffering, in order that many children to share His glory. For Jesus is the one who leads them to salvation. He purifies people from their sins, and both He and those who are made pure all have the same Father. That is why Jesus is not ashamed to call them His family. He says to God, "I will tell my people what you have done. I will praise you in their meeting." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hear the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Mark, chapter 10, verses 2 to 16. Glory to Christ, our Savior. Some Pharisees came to Him and tried to trap Him. "Tell us," they asked, "does our law allow a man to divorce his wife?" Jesus answered with a question, "What law did Moses give you?" The answer was, "Moses gave permission for a man to write a divorce notice and send his wife away." Jesus said to them, "Moses wrote this law for you because you are so hard to teach. But in the beginning, at the time of creation, God has made them male and female, as the scripture says, and for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and unite with his wife, and the two will become one. So they are no longer two, but one. No human being then must separate what God has joined together." When they went back into the house, The disciples asked Jesus about this matter. He said to them, "A man who divorces his wife and marries another woman commits adultery against his wife. In the same way, a woman who divorces her husband and marries another man commits adultery." Some people brought children to Jesus for him to place his hands on them. But the disciples scolded the people. When Jesus noticed this, he was angry and said to his disciples, "Let the children come to me and do not stop them, because the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. I assure you that whoever does not receive the kingdom of God like a child will never enter it." Then he took the children in his arms, placed his hands on each of them, and blessed them. This is the gospel of Christ.
O Lord.
In the name of God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear sisters and brothers in the Lord Jesus Christ, both those of you who are present here in our cathedral church and those of you who are joining us in worship at home. We give thanks to God for this day as we regather back in church, in God's house, as one body of Christ for worship and fellowship. And yet I know that the majority of you are only able to worship online, as church attendance is currently limited to 50 persons per service, or even lower in our smaller chapels. And some of you might even ask right away, where are the children? Why are they not welcome to attend church? Didn't we just hear it read in the gospel for today, Mark chapter 10, and especially verses 13 to 16, that children should be welcome? Wasn't Jesus indignant? Wasn't Jesus angry at the disciples because the disciples had tried to stop people from bringing children to Jesus? "Let the children come to me," said Jesus. "Do not hinder them." Then why are we not taking heed of Jesus' words? Why are we hindering children at worship? So some of you might ask. Sisters and brothers, the number of new COVID cases is still high, both here in Sarawak and Brunei Darussalam, where the government has just announced the introduction of more control measures, including night curfews from 8 p.m. to 4 a.m. and more enforcement activities. In Sarawak, the entire state is now in phase 3 of the National Recovery Plan, with the South Zone having transited from phase 2 to phase 3 on 1st of October. This enabled us to reopen our churches and chapel. But why limit the numbers? The answer is because we love you, because we care about you. And because we love and care about you, hence, we must make a cautious, careful, and responsible return back to church. We are putting your well-being, your welfare, your safety as our priority. We are doing our part to safeguard you. Hence, we are limiting the numbers and at the same time are discouraging children and vulnerable adults to attend church for now. Faith, science, and medical knowledge are never at odds with each other. Wisdom, after all, is from one God, the God whom we worship, whom we know in Jesus Christ. We wish to assure you that in the weeks and months ahead, we will slowly but surely increase our numbers, allowing more to gather in church. Yes, we do understand. We do understand your yearning to be in church together. In the gospel for today, Mark chapter 10, verses 2 to 12, we heard how the Pharisees came to Jesus. Their intention, sadly, was to test him. The Pharisees thought they were clever, even cleverer than our Lord Jesus Christ. They thought they could trap Jesus and put him to shame. Their question, or rather their trap question, was, is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife? Jesus gave them the benefit by asking, what did Moses command you? To which they replied, well, Moses permitted a man to write a certificate of divorce and send her away. Verse 4. And what was our Lord's answer to them? In verse 5, Jesus explained, it was because your hearts were hard that Moses wrote you this law. Jesus continued, but at the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. Verse 6. And verse 7, for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they're no longer two, but one. And verse 9, listen. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate. Friends, this COVID season is challenging time indeed. All of us have been and are, and sadly will continue to be affected and impacted one way or another. When we face challenges, when we face the storms of life, when we face crises, when we are not doing so well, or perhaps even when we are doing very well, it is tempting to have things our own way. You don't have something, you steal. When you are angry, you kill. You are jealous, you slander. You want to win, you bribe. You want someone else, you divorce. The Pharisees might think that they are okay because in their mind, their position was legal. They were wrong. Jesus told them that they must go back to the beginning. They must go back to God's original plan. They must go back to God Himself. And that, my dear sisters and brothers, we must do too. To go back to the beginning, to go back to God's original plan, to go back to God Himself. And so as we regather, we must not simply go back to church. We must go back to God Himself to be right with God again by going back to the beginning, by going back to God's original plan and purpose for us. That is what it means to be God's people, disciples of Jesus Christ. Our concerns must no longer be like those of the Pharisees, such as what is the minimum requirement for us to attend church in a year, or in my lifetime for that matter? What is the minimum sum I need to give? Do I need to sign myself with the sign of the cross from my left or from my right? Mundane questions. Friends, as we regather, as we begin anew, let us be mindful that we are returning, we are regathering as disciples of Jesus. And let us be intentional about what God is calling us to be, holding fast to God's intention for us as His people. COVID-19 has indeed placed us in the wilderness of life, of faith, of personal growth. Perhaps some of us have been out in the wilderness and in the darkness of this world. Let us regather ourselves. Let us regather our friends by encouraging them as well to hear God's love beating, to come to Him. And friends, if you hear God's voice today, today is the day of salvation. Today is the day to begin anew, to start again. God is actually giving us yet another opportunity. Therefore, we must not despise, we must not blow away this opportunity. Because as God's people, as we gather today, we offer God worship and praises for what God is offering to us yet again. As we gather, we thank our good Lord and praise Him for His everlasting love and mercy in preserving us, in sustaining us, in taking care of us. I do know that some of us may have gone through some very dark moments, scary time, and yet God has mercifully and graciously hold us in His hand. Shouldn't we praise, shouldn't we thank Him? Our God is a big, almighty God. And so as we gather, we bring to Him our hurt, our brokenness, even our anger, our fears, our anxiety, our uncertainty, even our doubts, our little faith and no faith. Let us bring them to God and offer them by placing them at the foot of Jesus' cross, before our Father's throne of grace. Let me say it again. We have a big, a gracious, a loving, merciful God. And to Him, we can bring our frustrations and our sense of hopelessness. Even as we continue to adhere to the SOPs and observe isolations and lockdowns and keep physical distancing. All of these are not comforting at all. They are not comfortable because we miss the presence and the company of our families, of our loved ones, of our friends and relatives, especially those whom we have not been able to see for a long time. Yes, indeed, we regather with a sense of loss and emptiness. Again, I do know that there are those of us who have lost our loved ones, friends and relatives as well. Some pass on due to COVID, and others succumbing to other causes. And we have not been able to celebrate or mark their passing in a way that we would love to, because of the strict SOPs. It is frustrating that we are not able to bid proper farewell to them and pay our last respect. Perhaps on that note, we must think deeply. Instead of being concerned with paying our last respect, let us consider paying first respect to each other. When we are alive and well, we do not have to wait until the moment of death to pay our respect, the last one. Pay each other first respect when we are alive and well, when we have plenty of opportunities to do so. Let this be part of the new normal for us. Indeed, this past year and a half, soon it will be 2 years, this has been the longest period of extreme difficulty and great challenge for all of us, with the pandemic crises and political upheavals. And together with the psalmist, we are asking God, God, how long? Psalm 13, how long will this period be? Sadly, the truth is, this COVID will remain with us for some time to come. We must learn to live with it, and we better be wise as God's people in living with it. Hence, we must adopt and adapt to the new normal. There is no way in which we can return to the old days, to the old ways. We all have seen and realized how short, how fragile life is. Let us live our life to God's glory, all of us, children included. Let us all, like little children, come to Jesus to be touched and blessed by him. Let us, with childlike faith, come to God to receive the kingdom of God. Verse 15. And so, my dear sisters and brothers, as we begin regathering in church, in our chapels, across the diocese, my prayer is that we will pay attention to the various SOPs and guidelines from us. Our PCCs and all our clergy have been entrusted to take care of you. Please pay attention and give them your best cooperation, so that we can gather to worship and have fellowship in a way that is safe, in a way that is glorifying to God as we build each other in the Lord Jesus Christ. Please stay safe, take care, God bless each and every one of you. In the name of God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
We stand for the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate of the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Please be seated. First, we would like to apologize for the hiccup earlier on. The technicians, they have mentioned to me that it will be uploaded later, but they just tells us that anything that is made by man, technology, as good as it is, will sometimes fail us. So pardon our technicians and pardon from our sides of the church. But I think Beyond that, it is good to see some of you back here in church. I know many others, they are also as eager to come back to church. Continue to pray for them, and I think hopefully we will all take our own turns. But may I please remind you to please adhere to our SOPs, and later for our Holy Communion, we will only be distributing the wafer, the bread, as it were. But don't worry, in our theology, our understanding of Holy Communion is this. The fullness of God's, or Christ's divinity is present in each element. That means in the bread alone, the full divinity of Christ is present, and also in the wine, it is also present. So don't worry if you receive in only one kind. And for as you come up afterwards, do follow the instructions of our wardens. With that, I won't keep you long. We continue our service with the intercessions.
In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you have promised through your Son, Jesus Christ, that when we meet in his name and pray according to his mind, he will be among us and will hear our prayer. Strengthen Donald, our bishop, Nelson, the assistant bishop, Tong Meng, our dean, and all in the service of Christ. We thank you that your children are able to return in your house of prayer. And since you have called us into the household of faith, keep us in fidelity of true religion. Help us to welcome the seekers, to nurture the faith of the young, and grant us your graces to receive and enter into your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Guide the rulers and all who lead in government within the Federation of Malaysia, the state of Sarawak, and the kingdom of Brunei Darussalam. Inspire with your wisdom those whose responsibility is to make laws and policies, and preserve in justice and righteousness those who administer them. Direct all peoples to walk in the ways of your truth and peace. Guide all efforts to recover amidst this pandemic and unite us, our work, for the well-being of all. Lord, in your mercy, bless our homes and protect each family. Guard the union of husband and wife, the care and concern between parents and children. Restore what has been broken in our relationships, and may your presence bring love, security, and truth. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heal those who are suffering in sickness or in pain. For Veronica Pong and Brahmat Anakumbang, who are seeking treatment in the hospital. For Lily Wee, Desen Anak Kipa, Deacon Philip Dennis Lim, Elsie Chan, Melvin Impi Anak Peter Mandi, James Muda, Ten Jun Pin, Winnie Irene Michael, Teo Kaluan, Datin Amar Valerie Wong, Mary Rudy Anak Rayut, Remy Anak Dana, Winnie Karani, and Raymond Morris Bujang, who are at home. Also for Gillian Neslin Dublin and Agnes Katit, who are at the quarantine center. Bless those who minister to their needs. Sustain the faith of those who are lonely, oppressed, and anxious, that they may know the strength and comfort of your presence. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hear us as we remember those who have died in the peace of Christ. For Laura Anak Jerusalem Linang, Tan Hock Beng, and Kelvin Anak Ong, they recently departed. Remembering E. Kim Seng, Ko Gek Yan, Rami, K. Yacho Anak Alfonso Kayu, Zacchaeus Anak Ansam, Luang Anak Idal, Julian Dana, Jelumi Anak Samat, Gan Seju, Percy Anak Belon, Lori Anak Mary, Yohanan John, Kawan Anak Lingo, and Matthew Chong Chi Hyung, whose anniversary of death falls at this time. According to your promises, grant us with them a share in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Rejoicing in the fellowship of St. Thomas, the Apostle, our patron, and all your saints, we commend ourselves and all for whom we pray unto your unfailing love. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Most merciful Lord, your love compels us to come in. Our hands were unclean, our hearts were unprepared. We were not fit even to eat the crumbs from under your table. But you, Lord, are the God of our salvation, and share your bread with sinners. So cleanse and feed us with the precious body and blood of your Son, that he may live in us and we in him, and that we, with the whole company of Christ, may sit and eat in your kingdom. Amen. Shall we all stand? We are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. You'll become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. The first Eucharistic prayer. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right. It is our duty and our joy, at all times and in all places, to give you thanks and praise. Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. For he is your living Word. Through him you have created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you have freed us from the slavery of sin, giving him to be born as man and to die upon the cross. You raised him from the dead and exalted him to your right hand on high. Through him you have sent upon us your holy and life-giving Spirit and made us a people for your own possession. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself, made once for all upon the cross, and proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. As we look for his coming in glory, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect sacrifice. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise, And as we eat and drink these holy gifts, in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, and with him, and in him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. As our Savior has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Be always with us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. May I now invite those who are streaming from home to make an act of spiritual communion. We say together, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Thank you. Let us pray. We praise and thank you, O Christ, for this sacred feast, for here we receive you. Here the memory of your passion is renewed. Here our minds are filled with grace, and here a pledge of future glory is given, when we shall feast at that table where you reign with all your saints forever. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. We stand to sing the recessional hymn, Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of Creation.
So wondrously reigns.